Previously on Dawgytrek.
They meet the girls, and I'm guessing this trip's gonna change very quickly. So look at Brandon. Light!
Here we are, we're on our way to Guilin.
To Guilin? Or something like that. Yeah, but anyway, it's only been about an hour and 20 minutes. Well, maybe an hour 40 minutes now. And we're already getting a little bored, a little stir crazy.
So many hours on the train. I can't even keep counting anymore. But here's one.
Alright,
ladies, so tell us your perception of Guilin so far. Fresh from the shower.
Smelling nice. Yes. I'm so proud of myself. You should have seen the backpack I took. It's just like that.
She brought nothing.
Really?
You didn't bring anything?
Before, did you?
I brought clean underwear.
We're here at this lake. There's some very wonderful looking pagodas across the room, this lake here. Very nice and peaceful. And having a great evening. The weather's nice. We're just taking our time exploring. But so far, Guilin's turned out to be very nice. And we're all just waiting to see what comes next. We're being stalked.
Yeah, I got him. I got him on camera.
Okay.
Okay, go ahead.
Somehow I don't think we're really going to chase him away, but we'll see what happens.
Okay.
I think we should just...
He's like right behind you.
Really? I think we should just hop into a cab and go back to our hotel.
He's right behind you, the guy in the red.
Yeah, it's kind of creepy.
Let's get
just
out of
a little
the,
bit.
I got him on camera. There he is right there.
Let's get out of this place.
To our viewers, this is Cranky Sue. Get to know her.
Right now, we're about to go watch a light show. And we are waiting. That's right. We are very, very bored and waiting. So, while we're waiting,
that was a mosquito.
Yeah.
So the show will happen right there as we speak. So right now it's not showing up, but eventually we will have it happen. Now I'm on the bike and I'm talking to the camera at the same time. It's pretty exciting. Got some really cool, exciting adventures coming around. And now I'm gonna cut the camera before I crash.
This is the river
where we watched the light show yesterday. And it's really interesting to see how there's a stone's throw away from where we're staying, and like hostels and tourist stuff built up, that we have this wide open area where, you know, people are still washing clothes by hand, and you know, life is a lot simpler. It's really illuminated. And,
we're off again to a different area. So here's some more of the village. And there's Sandy. Wave, Sandy. He's just enjoying himself.
Oh, he's like the little sarcastic
one.
We reached
this village to get lunch, and
no,
we're taking a boat
dumb.
Ride back to
today we're gonna be going to, I have no idea where the heck we're going, but it's another day of adventure. We're apparently gonna climb some mountains, and we're also gonna be checking out a cave. They say that this is a bigger cave than the one in Guilin, here in Yangshuo. So right now we're in this exciting cave, and as you can see behind me, got some really nice stalactites and stalagmites right over there. Nicely highlighted in color green. And it's a pretty exciting cave. Again, we're climbing another mountain. As you can see, it's not as hard as last time, but it's still, oh gosh.
Okay guys, this is a snail. And I'm now going to eat it. Gosh, what did I get myself into? Why am I doing this? Dogwood's easier because I hadn't seen it before.
Shut up.
It tastes so good. Actually, it's pretty good. It's kinda cool. This is our final day here. And on behalf of everybody, I'd like to give a special thank you to Sue for organizing this entire trip. This is, everybody, let's all say thank you to Sue.
Thank you, Sue.
最好的机会，感觉像灌一口冒着泡的快乐，向前飞无法复制的体会，唯有你解我的渴。